Hey everyone. This is Julia. Welcome to Coffee Time. Cheers. So this is my newest mug. It's from Le Creuset, and this is the flame color. And there's only one at the TJ Maxx that I went to, so I only have one of these, and I love it. I've only been using this mug this entire, like, week that I've had this mug, and yeah, it's amazing. The only downside is that it only fits, like, one finger, you know, I have to hold it like this. And I generally like mugs that I can put all four fingers so that it doesn't like slip, kind of like this one. But I still really like this mug. It's like really high quality. I like the color. The inside is like white, so, or like cream colored, so that you can see the color of your coffee. And yeah, it's just really beautiful and solid. So let's start with the vases because they're pretty big and heavy. Oh, everything is pretty heavy today because it's like kitchen related. But the first thing I want to share with you is this beautiful vase. It's by Haeger, which I learned last night. I was like looking through like a bunch of vintage Etsy accounts and stuff, like profiles, and seeing like what people sell and favoriting my favorite things. And they're all like dusty pink. But yeah, this vase is a Haeger vase, Haeger, and it's like such a beautiful vase. I saw this at the thrift store for like $2.99, and I was like debating whether I should get it or not because it was dirty. But the second time I went to this thrift store, I still saw it there, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna get it. Because when I came back home, I was like, I should have gotten that vase. So if that happens, you have to go back and get it. So I got that. And I put it through the dishwasher, and it's beautiful. This is the next vase. This is a ribbed cage. I don't know. It's like a Art Deco black vase. And I saw this also at the thrift store. The thrift store had like flowers, like fake flowers in it. And I missed it like the first 20 minutes that I was at the thrift store. But as I was like leaving, I saw it, and yeah, it's beautiful. The only thing is, I wish this was pink, like a dusty pink. And I saw a dusty pink version of this at a at like a thrift store, vintage store in Pasadena, California. So it was $50 then, and I was living with my parents, so I didn't like get anything that is too big. But yeah. This is such a beautiful piece, and I don't remember how much I paid for it. I think like $2.99 or $4.99 maybe. So that's the next piece. The next one is this one. Yesterday I found this beauty and I ran her through the dishwasher. I need to find names for my pieces. But yeah, there's no mark at the bottom, and it's such a pretty piece, and inside it's pretty clean. It was pretty clean before I put it to the dishwasher, so I mean, I put her anyway. But yeah, look at these colors. It's like a light blue and the dusty pink or light pink that I like. It has like an Indian theme to it, I don't know, but or Native American theme, or yeah, pattern. But yeah, I really like this vase, and it's really pretty. And I saved the best for last. This is my favorite phase of all time. I mean, okay, so I have a Golden Girls style going on. Like, I love anything Golden Girls-y, 1980s, 1990s, grandma, Florida style. And this reminds me of that exactly. And I love her so much. I forgot the brand of this one. I didn't run her to the dishwasher. I should, because it's kind of dirty inside. But actually, it's not too dirty. There's just a few like leaves and stuff. But yeah, I found this person, this face. Let's call her the Golden Girl face. I found her at a garage sale for $3. And I snatched her up so fast. Like, it was like a multi-family garage sale, and that specific garage sale didn't really have anything that either like I wanted or my boyfriend wanted. So that piece is just out of the world. So that's my vase collection, and I don't want too big of a collection because they're pretty big. And so they take up a lot of space, but right now they're sitting on a desk. Like, I have a desk that has like a lot of sections. I put them on in the different shelving sections, and I have a record player there too, so it kind of matches the decor a little bit. So first, I want to start with this item. This is actually one of my favorite, well, a lot of things are like my favorite finds, but in terms of like jewelry, this is like one of my favorite finds. I've been looking for a rotating earring thing like this. Like, I just want to hang my earrings because I like dangling earrings, and I just wanted something that's like easy to use, and I like things that rotate. So I found this at an estate sale for $1, and I was like about to leave the estate sale. They didn't really have too many things. I don't know why. I think it was because it was like the second or third day. And I saw this at in their garage. It was kind of like a garage sale type of like setup, and they had this. I was like, oh my gosh, it rotates. And I've been looking for something like this for such a long time. I like that it has a bird, and it has so many like little areas where you can hang your earrings. And this made me realize that I need more earrings, but I collect earrings only on my trips, so I need to go on more trips. But yeah, these are my earrings. I think some of my other earrings, I'm missing a lot of earrings. I think they're either in LA or let's choose an earring together. Right, so I'm gonna go with these. These are just purple. I like purple and like blue together. There you go. And I like that it has like an art deco like design on it. I don't know if you can see that well, but it's like a little like it looks like a little pillar. Okay. So let's get started with the kitchen items. I don't even know where to start. Let's start with the mugs that I got from thrift stores. And I just realized today, like, you don't really get a lot of mugs from thrift stores, even though I look at all the mugs at thrift stores. So the first one, this is not a thrift store, but it was like a garage sale, which I'm including as part of like thrift store finds. But this mug right here, this is by DEI. It's by, it doesn't really have a name. DEI, Reaping the Fun. And yeah, it's it's really pretty. I really like this mug. I love the handle. It's like sturdy, you know? And it's really pretty. I like ceramic things like this. I think this was like $3 or $2. And this is one that my boyfriend uses. And he really likes this mug. I'm now realizing that there's a little crack inside. If you can see, like, I just can't really see, but there's a little crack inside here that I'm just noticing. So, he really likes this Saturday Evening Post mug. And it's by, there's no brand, it's by Sherwood Brands of Rhode it's a Norman Rockwell thing. So those are the two mugs. Measuring things and stuff. My favorite. This is like, I get so much joy out of using this. It's a chicken measuring spoon. I mean, I don't even really like chickens all that much. Like, they're kind of scary to me because, I don't know, like, their necks are kind of scary. But I went to this estate sale that had like chicken everything. Like, everything was chicken. And the only chicken thing I got was this measuring spoon. So, yeah, this gets me, this makes me so happy. It's good with liquids like soy sauce, fish sauce, things like that, because it's like a U-shaped thing. It's not really good with like things like peanut butter or anything like sticky, like honey, because you have to like, it's hard to like put your spatula inside. But anyway, this makes me so happy. Like, spices also are, actually, no. Spices aren't good because it gets like stuck on these little things. But anyway, I guess it's not very practical, but I use it a lot. Put in the dishwasher. It's so easy. It's so cute. I love it. It was a dollar. And then the next thing I got, I don't remember whether this was. No, it wasn't the same garage. It wasn't the same estate sale. It was another person's estate sale. This lady really loved baking, and I actually really like the sound of this. But it's a has like a heart inside and has an angel, and it's a tablespoon set, measuring spoon set. So yeah, this is the teaspoon, half teaspoon, a quarter teaspoon, and these are like bigger than you would think. I really like the sound. Another measuring thing that I got from the thrift store, or actually this was an estate sale. This was 50 cents, and like measures, like it's really good for like honey, peanut butter, anything like sticky sauces. So you just like put this, like if you want to put 2 ounces, actually this side is tablespoons and cups, which is helpful. So it goes up to like half a cup. So if you want like half a cup of peanut butter, you put this to the half cup side, and then you fill your peanut butter, and then you just go and then it spills, like everything comes out. There's nothing here. And then I just use a spatula to scrape it off, and it works really well. I don't know what brand this is. Oh, it says right here, every EVRI measure. So that's what that is. And then what else? Let's do salt shakers. So this is my favorite salt shaker that I found. This was at a church like rummage sale. They had like you can get a brown paper bag and you can fill it up for $4. And so I was just like walking through, and this was in one of the tables, and I like reluctantly got this because I was like, yeah, I'll just get it because it fills the bag. But after I came home and realized what this was, I was like obsessed. This is by I don't even remember. Oh, I can't even see it. Mary Klein Ink. It's really hard to see, but it looks like this, and it has like an S. I don't have the P, cause but that's okay, cause I don't use like pepper stickers. But yeah, this works really well. It opens. Sorry, that's the sock. It opens really well. It opens really well, and I'm having a hard time opening it. Yeah, so it's really easy to open, and it has like one of these things. They just like put it in and turn it, and that's it. It's so easy to use. It's plastic, it's light, it pours really well. So you have to be kind of careful about putting too much salt and like popcorn and stuff, but I love this lady. Another salt and pepper shaker. It's like a, I don't know, oh, Mid-Century Modern, like a salt shaker. This was at this like grandma who like hoarded vintage things. I was pretty much in heaven. I went to the estate sale like 3 times, like 3 days in a row, because the third day was like half off. And this was still there during the third day, so I got it. And I was like $6. I think it was like $12, so I got it for $6. And yeah, I love it. It works really well. This pepper shaker works better than my pepper shaker that I used, which is an OXO pepper shaker. I'm gonna put this away. So this is like this is what I currently use right now, and I need to replace the label. I'm like, I have an ongoing list of things I need to relabel and everything. So I'm just waiting a little bit. But yeah, this is my pepper shaker and I don't really like it. It's at the finest setting. Right here. This is at the very right, which means it should be small, but it's like big. I get like big chunks of pepper, which I don't really like. So, I mean, that's what I use right now. But I really like that. The holes at the top so that it's not, you don't have to have anything at the bottom. So that's that. And I got that at Bed Bath & Beyond when they had a store. Another salt and pepper shaker that I got that I don't really use as a salt and pepper shaker, but I use it as a decor on top of my stove are these little blue birds. I mean, these are really cute. There's 3 holes in the other. There's 3 and 5 holes. This bottom is broken. I didn't run her through the dishwasher. Like, no. Like, this is good. And yeah, it's just so cute. So cute. Hello. Hi. How are you doing? Good. How are you? Good. Do you want a kiss? Okay. So they're lovebirds. Some other things. Let's go with the plate. So I found this blue plate. So the thrift store I usually go to, it's called Salt and Light in Urbana. It's amazing. When you go in there though, it looks like crap. In the nicest way. Like, it just looks like this big place where it doesn't have anything. You really have to dig through the stuff. They have like, I mean, yesterday I had like a big day. But yeah, I got this. And this, I don't remember how much this was, maybe like $1.99 or $2.99. Everything is pretty much $1.99, $2.99 there. And yeah, it's by Flat Earth. And it's, I think it's made in 88. So this is the back. And I ran this to the dishwasher. I pretty much run everything through the dishwasher if I can. And right now, this is like sitting next to my stove area, and I put some other vases on here. So yeah, this is really pretty and some things I put on there is this heavy pot. Oh, I need to clean it. But yeah, this is by our PR Story Pottery Co. from Marshall Company. And I honestly didn't know how to use this pitcher, but yeah, I'm using this to carry my utensils. And a lot of my utensils are like plastic and wood because I don't like using metal on my pots and pans because I have some nonstick pots and pans and of the heart thing. And another thing is this little tiny pitcher. I mean, how cute is this? I love blue. I love blue. And I love like old things. Like I love vintage things. And so this is by Marshall, Texas, Yesteryear. And I think it's just really, really cute. And I keep my little little things. This is my little utensil holder. So I have this like nice spatula. I actually use this the most out of all of my spatulas because I love scraping things. Like it's just very satisfying to use. I will use it for like everything. I also got this like little tiny whisk. This is good for like little sauces and stuff. I use this mainly for my patio sauce because I make my sauce ahead of time, but it has sugar in it, and the sugar always kind of like settles down at the bottom, so it's good for that. And then I also found this at a thrift store. I think this was at the at Salt and Light, but yeah, it's just kind of loud because I have a lot of like metal spoons or metal bowls. So I honestly don't really use this as much as I'd like to, but I know Stolatabla has these and they're like $16 to $28. So yeah, I got that. Right, there's a lot. Let's do pots next. So this was at the Hoarder estate sale, and I just think this is just adorable. I got this for like $4 at the last day of the sale. This is the Countryside Collection made in Taiwan, and yeah, I guess I burned it a little bit. But yeah, this made me realize that I'm mainly left-handed when it comes to like pouring things. I have much better control with my left hand, and I also like brush my teeth with my left hand. Anyway, this is a right-handed like pouring thing because it has like a lip. But yeah, it also works on the using my left hand. But yeah, I really love this design. It's just really, really cute, and yeah, I use it a lot. This doesn't really work for like instant noodles though because the inside is like small, so the instant noodle is like too big for this pot. So yeah, I have another pot for that. Pot I use for instant noodles is this one. This one I got from the thrift store. It's just a solid, like solid pan made in the USA. It's called Wherever. I know the bottom looks awful, but it's one piece of solid stainless steel, and look at the inside. It's just like perfect. The handle is a little wobbly, and I don't know how to fix that. But I got this for like $1 or $2, and it's solid. I love it. Yeah, I just need to fix the handle a little bit. I love things that are like made in the US because they tend to be like really durable. All right. So next thing I'm going to show you is this extremely heavy marble spinning thing. Let me just set it up real quick. All right, so I set it up, and this is the marble spinner, or Lazy Susan, I guess. And I love her. She's really heavy. I found her like at an estate sale underneath a bunch of like pots and pans. So you kind of do have to dig through, and it's very heavy. I love marble anything. Right now, I'm using this inside one of my cabinets next to my stove, and I put like my salt and pepper shakers, some spices that I use, some sauces, and I just like rotate her whenever I need something, and it's really handy for like inside your cabinets, so that you don't have to like dig it, you know. And I take things out to like nothing from the back. So that's another item. One thing I got that I don't really use. This is probably like, yeah, I don't really use this that much. It's this garlic press. I got this at the house that had a lot of like vintage stuff. And yeah, I don't really use it that much. It's because when I put garlic in here and I press it down, most of the garlic comes out this way instead of this way. And I think it's because the holes are like too small. So I don't really use that much. Unless I just want like pressed garlic. I love things with like recipes, and I got this blueberry pie dish, and I'm in love. I love things with recipes, and especially like pie dishes. Like, I just saw like a strawberry pie one, and I didn't get that one because it wasn't pretty. Like, the strawberry color was like kind of faded, but I mean, what a beauty this is. I don't even know who made it. It's made in China. Microwave, dishwasher, and oven safe. And so, yeah. I may or may not make a blueberry pie. Just, I like blueberries, but I don't want to make pie because I'm scared of making the crust. I have stories. All right. One of my favorite bowls that we use a lot of is this popcorn bowl, and it looks like that. That's all, folks. And it's made in Marshall, Texas. It's the same brand as the pictures that I showed you, but we love this popcorn bowl. We use it for popcorn a lot. We used it last night for popcorn, and we also use it for salads, because it's just the perfect bowl for salads. Alright, one moment. Next up is my little duck containers. This is made by, it's made by, but I keep my like almonds in here, and I have a measuring spoon. This is from Uncommon Coffee Roaster. So we got this at our trip from trip to Michigan, Holland, Michigan, and I love it. It's a good like portion size, so yeah, I'll put it back in after, but I just love ducks like this. And yeah, there's two other ones. This one has like rice that my boyfriend bought a while ago that we just don't know. We just haven't used it yet. So what I did was I cut up the instructions and put it inside here, so that if we ever need to make this, we know how to do it. And then this one just has the Amish noodles that we just haven't used yet. So, another thing that I got that's like duck related is this sugar canister. And honestly, thinking back, I should have bought like the other two sizes that was this. And I use it for sugar. I keep this actually on here in my cabinet, so that if I just need like a tablespoon of sugar, I just use this. I'd have to like go to the pantry and get the sugar out, you know, like it's a lot of work. So yeah, I think this is just really cute and I don't know who makes it, but I love this. Okay, so another thing I got that's related to like recipes and stuff is this gingerbread cookies like mitten holder, and it's not homemade, I guess. I want to make this during Christmas, and I think it'll be fun. So I might just hang this too. This might be really cute for like Christmas decoration. So it's practical and functional. One thing I got from the Baker estate sale is this, like, it's a rolling pin thing. So you just put this on your rolling pin, and you just like roll it out so that it's the same size. Really pretty. So it's from King Arthur Flower. I just got this. I don't know. And then you never know, like when you need certain things, right? And I have a lot of like these types of bowls or like baking dishes. We get them from the Soap & Light. Have a lot of them. And anytime we see them with the lid, we try to get it, and yeah, we have like, I don't have the lids with me, but like I found this one, for example, for with the lid for $2.99, and I love it. Look, this is Corningware. Corningware is like one of my favorites when it comes to like thrift store finds. It's just, so anytime I see those, I will get it. What else is there to show you? I think that is everything. Yeah, I do have one more thing I want to show you. That is this timer. Okay, so at estate sales, you can find these things. They go for a dollar, and it makes life really much easier. So what this is there's only one, it's only useful for one lamp. You put your lamp in, and it's a timer for when your lamp goes on. So your lamp is always on, but then you can set it so that it turns on at like 4 p.m. And that's how I set it up right now. I end work at 4:30 to 5 to 5:30. So to kind of signal that it's time to relax, I have it set so that it turns on at 4:30, and then it's off. It turns off at like 11:30 p.m. I usually go to bed around 11 o'clock. So to change the time to when it turns off, you just take this out and put it in the 12 o'clock one. And then if I want to turn it on at 4 o'clock, then you just put it in the 4 o'clock. And then you just set it. What time is it right now? Like in the middle. So right now it's 12:30. So I just need to like turn this a little bit. It's 12:30 right now. And then once you plug it in with the lamp inside here, it'll start going, and then it'll turn on at like 4 o'clock and turn off at 11 o'clock. And that has been so, like, it just makes me like so happy during the day when I'm at home. Like, light just turns on, and yeah, it's one of those things that you don't really have to think about. I feel like it's like a secret that no one has told me, and my boyfriend's parents actually have this like all over their house, so when it turns like 5 o'clock, everything turns on, like all the ambient lighting turns on. So yeah, it's easy, an easy thing to do for your house that makes your life enjoyed this video, and I'm sorry that I was like off camera a lot of times. I'm in a weird setting right now because I have a lot of things everywhere. Enjoyed my thrift store hauls, and I hope this inspires.